The condition that I was born with was amniotic band sequence. My leg was stunned, so it didn't formulate and grow all the way. It grew partially. So that forced me to wear an orthotic brace. With it being new, there wasn't a lot of braces that had those many features of a regular brace or a regular foot. I actually met Dr. Zubala right before he was on his trip to one of the overseas programs.
I began talking with him about his interest, and I was somewhat deferring him a meeting until I got back into town. And then he rolled up his pants leg, and I saw that he was actually wearing one of these orthotics. And so that hit me pretty hard, pretty quickly, and it really made it clear to me how important and how personal that research was to Key. And so I turned around, opened my door to my office back up, and we sat down and started talking about ways that we could start working with him and with the lab.
So the goal is to create this orthotic out of 3D printing materials as much as possible. And they're not normal shapes, right? They're very organic. And Shannon was really great at, you know, manipulating those shapes in SolidWorks so we could go from SolidWorks to 3D printing.
It was something where she was like, I don't know how to do this, so I'm asking you to figure it out. And so I spent a while going through different forums and help pages of SolidWorks to try and figure out a solution of how I can make a custom orthotic.
The extra effort we put into making this a robust design to be used with anything was able to so easily convert over to what Key needed.
This is one of my main passions of going to school, trying to figure out how can I put a dent in this area, because for one, the braces are extremely expensive. They're $4,000 to $5,000 per brace without insurance.
So we've been able to take what he's had and improve that to about like $14.72. And then he can have that in 3 or 4 hours versus, you know, having to schedule an appointment.
I met Key once when I was first pretty much doing research in the lab. And I remember him coming in and very excited about, hey, let's make an orthotic using, you know, the latest technology that there is.
So when I got here, I was like, yeah, man, let's incorporate. I want to be able to wear flip flaps. I want to see what it feels like to wear flip flaps and whatnot. So we talked to the guys, the whole team, we can make that happen.
We put his name in it, the Auburn logo and all of that.
We worked with it. Like it was a collaborative effort.
So the fact that you're working with people is a big deal. A lot of projects that you do for classes and stuff, they seem not pointless, but just work for the sake of doing work, not work for a passion or a purpose.
A lot of times it's equations, mathematics, and it's very impersonal. But when you get to the point of the human, it becomes personal, it becomes more emotional. And there's other things to consider beyond just the objective truths, but about how people feel.
I feel like we're actually impacting a lot of people now that maybe all went through the same things that I went through. For me being able to impact not alone myself, but other individuals who may be faced with this, that's what I was here for.